By the end of this video, you'll be able to create an AI agent workflow on N8N that generates beautiful Instagram or TikTok reels and posts it to your socials automatically, together with impactful captions. First, we're going to leverage the latest video generation models like Seedance or Veo 3 and send those videos to a social media posting workflow. Whether it's for Instagram, TikTok, LinkedIn, or other socials, this workflow will work for all of them. So, let's get right into it. Jumping right into the build. This workflow consists of two parts. The first part is very similar to what I've built for Seedance in my last video, so you can check that out. I'll link it up there and down here as well. In this video, I'm just gonna build it out very quickly. Instead, I'm gonna use Veo 3 as the video generator. And then the second bit is where we're gonna build out the automated social media posting element to it, right? So there is a tool called Botato that we're gonna leverage in order to post to our Instagram and TikTok and other social accounts. In this case, I'm just gonna do an example on Instagram. The others are kind of very similar, so we can go off from there. The first trigger for the first part, which is the video generation part. And by the way, if you're already familiar with this, you can skip to basically just the next part. But in this case, I'm gonna introduce the chat trigger as a trigger node. And the reason why I want to use a chat trigger, I want to be able to tell the workflow kind of the topical or thematic Instagram reel that I want. However, if you want it to just be on schedule every day, generating the idea, generating the actual video and creatives without you supervising it, you can absolutely do that. You can just change the trigger node to on schedule. But in this case, I'm just going to do a chat trigger for now. And I'm just going to type in hello, because I want it to populate the variables. And then the second node that we're going to introduce here is the OpenAI node. Just close that message model. And basically, this is just a AI video prompt agent. And what it does is basically it takes your input and creates a video, an effective video prompt for the next node, which is going to be the HTTP API endpoint node. I'm just going to call on that API, which is a Wastefeed API in this case, to use or invoke Veo 3 to generate the video. So we want to make sure that the prompt that it receives is very effective, because having an effective prompt for video generation is really half the battle in making sure that it gives out quality content. So from the list of this, I'm going to pick GPT-4. And of course, the user prompt is the chat input that's coming in. And I'm going to add a system prompt as well. In this case, I have something that I've written. So this is something that ChatGPT has generated in terms of this prompting it. So it says, your creative video prompt generator for short form, okay, these shouldn't be ads, they should be reels. Based on the chat input of the user, your task is to craft elaborate visual descriptive video generation suitable for input for Seedance or Veo 3 API. It doesn't really matter, to be honest. We'll give it an example of what's a good prompt. All right, I'm going to remove the 5 seconds because that's from somewhere else. But anyway, I'm going to execute step. And there you go. So this is the video prompt that it's going to send to the HTTP node. Now I'm going to introduce a HTTP request, which is a post request node. And actually what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my Wastefeed account. And again, if you don't know, or if you don't already have a Wastefeed account and you want to see how to set up, please check out my other video where I can go through step-by-step on how to sign up and everything on Wastefeed. So as you can see, there are a couple models on Wastefeed that you can choose from. Typically what I do is just go down here and type in Veo 3. If you are looking for Veo 3, if you're looking for other stuff, but they've got Seedance and all these other good ones as well. But in this case, we're going to use Veo 3 fast.
Yo, Google Veo 3 fast!
And essentially, you want to go to the API section. But right before you do that, just make sure that you're getting the description and the aspect ratio correctly. So for Instagram and TikTok, the correct aspect ratio is 9 to 16, so you're going to pick that. The duration by default is 8 seconds. And then, of course, if you want audio, make sure that you check the audio for video as well, and it'll tell you how much it costs to run. And this is actually pretty expensive. Veo 3 has, to me, at the very least, pretty costly as compared to other models. So that's why I think Seedance has its interesting use case as well. But essentially, we have all of that, and we toggle over to API, and we want to copy the curl command. And then let's go back to the HTTP request node and just paste the entire thing into the import curl command. You get all of these filled up pretty nicely. Authentication, as always, pick on generic credential type. Make sure that you're picking the header auth. I've already set this up before in my other video, so again, you can check that, but it's pretty easy. Once you set it up, you can toggle this off. You don't need to send any headers. And here you go. This is the JSON body. Aspect ratio, as you can see, is 9 to 16. Duration, 8 seconds. Generate audio is true, so we want it to have audio. And then under prompt, this is where you want to make sure that you are inputting the variable from the previous node, which is the video prompt generator. I'm going back to the chat. So this is a request that I want to go to Veo 3, which is to create an Instagram reel for my channel, Automate with Mark, an automation tutorial channel of a newscaster announcing the release of a new video for Automate with Mark on Primetime News. Let me just hit enter for that. It's going to send it to the video prompt agent, and then it's going to send it to the HTTP request node, which is now sent to basically Wastefeed or Veo 3, right? Now, the next node that we want to do is just a wait node, because once you post a request, you need to wait for it to generate the video. So we're going to wait 30 seconds. Also execute that. And then while that's running, we can introduce a HTTP GET request. And again, toggle back to Wastefeed. All right. And copy that, import that curl command for GET. And it's just this URL, actually. Authentication, select the same the header authentication. Toggle that off. and everything else just remains the same. What you want to do is change this request ID back to the request ID from the wait node. So you want to toggle that to expression and then drag this to right in between the two slashes there. So once you execute step, what you get is actually this whole chunk of information. Again, with this, you want to take a look at the status. So the status is still processing. What this means, I'm going to rename this, by the way, HTTP GET request. What that means is that the video is still being processing. So you got to wait a while longer. In this case, what we want to do is we want to introduce another if node. And the reason why I want to do that is because we're going to create a loop. And we're going to take the GET request output, which is, yeah, there you go. So the status, which is processing, if the status is processing, then this is true. We're gonna go for another wait node, which is another wait 30 seconds. Okay, and then I'm gonna loop it back to the GET request. The logic is, if the GET request returns that the status is still processing, it's gonna wait another 30 seconds, I'm gonna try to get it again. If that's still not ready, it's still gonna say processing, and then it's gonna come back here. But if it's ready, then this variable will say completed and not processing. And in that case, what happens is it becomes false, and it goes to the next node, which in this case, I want it to be another OpenAI message and model node for captions, right? So we want to make sure that the video reel comes with some form of captions for the Instagram or TikTok. So in this case, we're going to choose a GPT latest because it's not using any tool. We just wanted to come up with the right text. And for the user prompt, I'm going to have to execute the previous node. Just to double back, what we want to do is we want to get the video prompt. And sometimes this happens, right? It says no field node executed. It's not showing you anything, any information. So what you want to do is just toggle to the table and go here, and it will show, you know, the content of the prompt. So the reason why I want to drag this here is because I want to say that based on this video generation prompt, create an impactful accompanying caption for the Instagram post. And then I'm going to accompany the video prompt because it describes what the video is. This node, because it is a caption agent node. So this is a caption writer. And in order for it to write a coherent caption, it needs to know what the video is about, right? So it can't read the video. The easiest context that we can give it is basically the prompt to the video, which is in text. And we're going to pass that over here so that it does actually know what goes on in that video, right? And then I'm going to add another message here, which is a system message. And again, I've got this typed out by ChatGPT. Actually, no, I typed it out myself. So it's just, you're an Instagram caption copywriter. You receive a set of video prompt messages used for generating Instagram short real video. Your job is to write effective accompanying caption. Language style should be playful and impactful. Okay, so that is my caption agent. I'm going to execute step. All right, there you go. So breaking news, brand new tutorial just dropped. Da, da, da. The next node after the caption agent is the Google Sheet node, right? This is where all the video captions, video descriptions, and video URLs are stored before it gets passed on to the social media posting workflow, which is the second part of this workflow, right? What we want to choose here is a pen, row, and sheet. Now, I'm going to show you what the sheet looks like. So the sheet looks like this. It's pretty simple. Nothing fancy with this. It just needs four components. And I'll share the template of this below in the description, but you actually can just build it yourself, right? Just make sure that you have all these four components, which is the description to identify what kind of video it is, so you don't have to click on the URL every time. You know that you have a video URL column, and then you have the video caption column, and then you have the status, whether it's posted or to be posted, right? Going back to the workflow, what you want to do is you want to pick the sheet and document, append row, and pick videos to log of videos to publish, which is the name of the sheet, and then sheet one. And basically, it's going to fetch all the columns that exist in that sheet. So as you can see, there's description, URL, caption status. And it will make a bit more sense later as we build a second part of the workflow why we need all of this, right? Essentially, the video description or the prompt is going to come from the prompt agent. So I'm going to drag the content here. The purpose of this is really, I think I accidentally click on a delete button. Okay, there we go, it's back. Essentially, yes, video description, the purpose of that is to tell you what is the content of the video without having to click on a URL. And of course, you can name it, you can have a title as well. That's easier, but this works for me. With the video URL, what you want to do is to go to the if node. Again, sometimes this happens where it says no fields. What you want to do is toggle back to table, go to if, and make sure that you drag the output here, right, to the video URL. And then in terms of caption, go back to caption agent, grab the content from the caption, drop it in. There you go. And then status. The status basically, again, is here. And there are three that you can choose from, posted, ready, post, in progress. It matters if you're splitting the workflow into two workflows, but in this case, because it's one entire workflow, it doesn't matter as much, but it helps in terms of making sure that you can keep track in terms of what is ready to post, what are being in progress, and what's being posted, right? But anyway, you wanna make sure that the status here is ready to post so that it reflects correctly on the sheet. So I'm gonna execute step. And it's gonna append a row in that sheet. So as you can see, this is the prompt, this is the URL, this is the caption, and this is ready to post. Okay, so now I'm kind of curious what kind of reel that VO3 has generated. So I'm just gonna click on that, take a look at a reel. All right, there you go.
New video has been released on the channel. All right. Kind of messed up the last bit with automate with Mark there, but yeah, I mean, DO3 has definitely a pretty good quality. Always a good option, just that we have to live with the cost that comes with it, right? So after the Google Sheet, all this information, we want to be pushing it onto a tool called Potato. So Potato is going to automate all the social media posting, and you could basically post to your Instagram, TikTok, LinkedIn, whatever you have. But what you want to do is just head over to potato.com, and I'm already signed up, but if you haven't, you can do so. It's pretty straightforward, but essentially, I'm just going to log in and show you guys how it looks like. And you're gonna be led to a page like this, right? So when you try to sign up, they will need your credit card details. However, you do get a 14-day free trial to just kind of play around a little bit. However, that doesn't include the API key function, right? So in this case, the way we wanna go is just go to settings. And you're gonna be led to this page where you can connect all your accounts, all your social accounts from Twitter, LinkedIn, Facebook, TikTok, Instagram, whatever you have, to Potato. So that's the very first step that you need to do, is to just link your account. In this case, I've already linked my Instagram account. And that's the only one I'm gonna do for this example, because I just wanna try to keep it simple. But every one of these have the same kind of workflow and have the same kind of structure. So once you know how to do it for one, you can just duplicate and do the same for others. We're gonna focus on Instagram for today. What you do is set up and just connect. It's super simple to connect as well. Just click on that, your Facebook's gonna be activated, and basically just log in and you'll be connected. Anyway, after you've done that, what you wanna do is go to help, because that's where you're going to find the documentation for end-to-end. So you can go through the documentation on how to set up the API calls through end-to-end, and it's got a pretty good documentation, but I'm going to give you guys a shortcut. So you can go back to your workflow and do a set note. And what you want to do is just do a JSON. And I'm going to link this JSON chunk in the description below. But you can find this in the documentation as well, right? So as you can see, these are basically the credentials or the ID or the keys that you need to access your social media accounts. So as you can see, you don't have to fill in each and every one of this. So like, for example, if you're just going to do Instagram, you can just put in the Instagram key and ignore the others and send it as a chunk. It doesn't matter. But in this case, what we're going to do is we want to make sure that the Potato API key is in here. So what you do is go back to Potato and go to settings, yes. Just scroll further down to this part here. So you can see now you have the API access, and you can click on the copy API key. And again, fair warning, if you're on the free trial, the moment you click on this button, you're gonna start getting charged, right? So just to let you know that this is a paid feature. So once you have the key, go back here and just paste the API key, right? And then you also need the Instagram ID. So how do you get the Instagram ID? Just go back to Potato. So you can see the connected accounts here, copy account key, and go back to the workflow, and there we go. So today we're just gonna do the Instagram ID. So I'm just gonna do that, execute step, there we go. So we've set the social accounts here. The next note we want to do is a HTTP request note. And this is going to be a post request, because what we want to do is upload to Potato, right? And the reason for this is that because the URL that we currently have on the sheet is kind of a random URL, right? And some of these social media platforms are pretty picky in terms of what kind of URLs they allow to post directly onto, you know, their social media platform. So what Potato does, it provides this kind of repository where you can upload all your videos, and provides a link that is already pre-verified. There's an approved domain for these social media platforms. So just make sure that everything works well and smooth and easy, right? So you're going to do a post request here, and essentially we can go to upload. And you can see the documentation here, the URL, etc., right? And you're gonna post it to this particular URL authentication. You're gonna need to set that up. I've already set mine up, but I'm gonna set it up again. So just create credential, Potato, and API key, demo. Okay. So the name should be Potato_API_key, and then the value, of course, I'm just gonna toggle this to expression, so you can see what I'm tapping in. It's just the API key, and I'm just gonna paste everything there and click on save. Cool, okay, the header auth is now done, and then now we wanna send a JSON body, and in this case, it's gonna be URL, and we're gonna grab from the previous notes, from the Google Sheet notes, the video URL here. All right, so this is going to upload to Potato. I'm gonna hit execute step. Authorization failed, so I've typed something wrong there. So let's see. So as you can see, it's not Potato_API_key. It's actually this one. So I'm just going to copy this, go back, and change the credential type. Changing the credential type here to Potato-API-key. I'm going to hit save. And all right, I'm going to try to execute step again. All right, there you go. So we've got a output of a URL, which is now where the video is stored in the Potato database. So after uploading the video URL or the video to Potato, the next note that you want to hit is the HTTP post request note. And this is basically posting the video to be published to the social media platform of your choice. In this case, the URL to hit is this one. And basically all the information that you need, you know, you can come to this page, basically publish post v2. And you should have all that here. Authentication, we're going to use generic credential, header auth, again, pick the same one. and of course, JSON body. We're gonna use raw JSON, and this is a chunk that you wanna copy in. Okay, so just to blow that up, essentially what we're doing is we're grabbing the text, which is the caption from the Google Sheet. So now it says this caption here, which is correct. And the media URL basically is the JSON.URL of the previous node, which is the upload rotated node. And I'm just dragging the URL here. And then account ID, essentially, I'm gonna go to edit fields, which is the set fields, and just to name that correctly. And just add, I think I'm missing another one there. Oh, it's already there. Okay. Oops. Should be. Yeah. Okay, let's try the execute step. And there you go. This has already been posted to the Instagram. So let's go to Instagram, or rather my Instagram page, and see if it's posted there. Sometimes it takes a while. So there you go. So this is a post that was posted. So let's see.
On the channel. New video has been released on the channel.
Okay, with the right captions here as well. And of course, this is not actually the video that I'm going to, so I'm going to delete this. It's not the actual reels I'm going to post. Of course, there's a bit of housekeeping required and making sure that the wordings and the words in the videos are correct. So a couple of tweaks that needs to be done, but essentially, as you can see, all this can be automated basically by this workflow, right? One last thing you want to do just before you end off is to have another Google Sheet note at the end of it. And the reason for that is because we want to make sure that basically going back to the sheet, right? We want to make sure that this is already posted, has already been posted. So this needs to be toggled automatically to post, which is why we're doing this. Append and update row, and the list is still the same list. Sheet one. Okay, the column to match on is basically, we want to match the video URL. It doesn't matter, actually, you can use the other ones too, which is a video description, but video URL. So you want to take from Google Sheet. So this particular video URL is what we're using to match. And then the values to send, we don't need to update these. We just need to update the status to just want to make sure that I'm writing it correctly. Post it, right? Post it, and I'm going to execute step. All right, there you go. So now the status is posted. Cool, so that completes the entire workflow. It's a pretty lengthy one, as you can see. Typically, if you want the troubleshooting to be easier, what you can do is you can split these workflow to two. How you do that is basically just to end the first part of the workflow at the Google Sheet portion. It just uploads it to the Google Sheet, and then you have another workflow which fetches the Google Sheet, fetches from the Google Sheet, the information required to upload to Rotato, and then to basically publish. Let me name this to publish to IG, and then update the Google Sheet after that. I hope that was helpful. It's certainly a pretty cool workflow to me, being able to automate all the posting to Instagram, generate all the content, and then be able to post that automatically without me having to check or anything like that. But of course, in real life, before you do this, I would recommend having some form of human in the loop type of situation in some parts of this workflow, especially before publishing it. If you're interested to see how we can build that, let me know. I'll do another video on how we can incorporate that into the workflow. I hope that workflow was helpful. And if you're facing any difficulties in any part of this workflow, let me know, comment down below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And of course, if you have any other ideas on what kind of workflow that you want to see me build, please let me know. And of course, if you enjoy the content and find it valuable, please consider subscribing. It will help me out a lot. And do a thumbs up if you like this video also. Otherwise, I'll see you guys in the next one.